Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My brothers and sisters, I greet you from the holiest place, the holiest masjid on earth. This is the Kaaba in the center of the earth. This is Al-Masjid Al-Haram in Makkah Al-Mukarrama, the house built by Ibrahim alayhi salatu wa salam, mentioned in the Quran. Inna awwala baytin wudi'a lin-nasi lalladhi bi-Bakkah. Indeed, this is the first house built for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or put for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on earth. And that is the house in Makkah al-Mukarrama. This is the beautiful home, the beautiful house in fact. It's not called a home, it's called the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And indeed, it is the most blessed place. There are people here from all over the world, each one of them with one intention, to earn the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Each one of them here to share the beauty of this deen. My brothers and sisters, just like I call you my brothers and sisters, I've met hundreds of people here, and as you can see, there are tens of thousands, if not hundreds of thousands of people here. The time is 2:15 in the morning, and it is alive. It is actually very, very busy. It is buzzing. There are people from all over, subhanallah. And people from every nationality you can think of, subhanallah. I've met people from all over the world. Countries that I did not know actually existed. Names that we were not familiar with. And people of all races, sizes, backgrounds, male, female, people from all the continents, all here in order to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in order to call out to Him, in order to clear the record with Him. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for every one of you to come here again and again. And all those who are watching, those who may watch later on, and the entire ummah, may Allah bless you in every single way. My brothers and sisters, I'm standing here in front of this house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, asking Him to grant cure to all those who are sick and ill across the globe, to grant mercy to those who've passed away from the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to grant guidance to those who are misguided, and to grant all those who are struggling in any way ease, to pray for our brothers and sisters who are suffering across the globe, in Syria, in Iraq, in Afghanistan, in Pakistan, in Bangladesh, in India, in all these countries, subhanallah, Somalia, Sudan, Yemen, everywhere else, even in the countries, the first world countries where there is Islamophobia. I ask Allah to create ease for us all, to educate those who are misguided, the non-Muslims who don't understand Islam, who think it is a religion of hate, and it is a religion of terrorism, it is a religion of disaster. May Allah guide them to understand that it is actually a religion of peace. Just look at these people. They've been here for years on end, every single day, 24 hours a day. Different people coming from different parts of the world. Extremely peaceful, extremely beautiful, very serene, very peaceful. This place has some amazing feeling here. It is something unique. It is something that I cannot explain. Something that you need to come here in order to understand. So my brothers and sisters, I really pray for everyone from this beautiful place, from this elevated place, a house built for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, initially by Ibrahim alayhi salam, and thereafter initially by Adam alayhi salatu wa salam, and thereafter by Ibrahim alayhi salatu wa salam. Also, the circumambulation was taught to us by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We don't worship the house, we worship the Lord of the house. There are people here crying for their needs. People here, male and female, as you can see, the rich and poor, everyone is just a person. Myself, no matter how much I may be known on the networks or the internet, etc., trust me, when I'm here, I'm just a single person, subhanallah. Just one person, exactly like everyone else. And this is the gift of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for us, that we are all human beings, we are all equal, we all have the same access to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We all have the same access to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Everyone who is here crying out to their Lord, their Maker. And I pray that everyone who's watching as well is granted forgiveness and goodness. And everyone who will see this later on, and the Ummah at large, may Allah bless us all as an Ummah. My brothers and sisters, look at the love. Look at the brotherhood. Look at the bond. Look at the people here. Everyone, what unites them is La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah, the Shahada. And amazingly, this is the very message of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to learn to respect every single person, those who are human beings and even the creatures of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We respect them. We respect every single one of them, subhanallah. The creatures of Allah, the connection between us and the rest of the creatures is that we have been created by the same Maker, subhanallah. He who made me has made the rest of creation. And this is absolutely amazing. I'm going to show you the people, and it's just, it brightens the night, should I say. If you look at what it looks like here, it's actually daylight. That's what it looks like. But to be honest, it's 20 past 2 in the morning here in Makkatul Mukarrama. And look at this, subhanallah, it's amazing. It's something unique. Like I said, I cannot describe this. This feeling here, may Allah bring you here to see and to feel and to gain that closeness to Allah and to reconnect with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah bless all of you. I'm looking at all the comments. I'm looking at all the comments, subhanallah, and I'm really feeling the brotherhood. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to fulfill the needs of every one of you. Those who are in debt, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help you pay off that debt. May He create a miracle for you. Those who are sick, may Allah create a miracle for you, grant you cure. Those who've lost loved ones, may Allah grant you sabr. May Allah grant them Jannatul Firdaus. Those who have indeed, those who are going through any form of hardship and difficulty, those who are struggling in countries where they cannot fulfill their deen, may Allah make it easy for you. May Allah guide the misguided, those who do not like the deen, those who actually are thinking very bad about Islam, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide them, grant them the necessary hidayah and education to be able to learn what this deen is all about. It's a beautiful faith, subhanallah. It is something that speaks for itself. Like I said, if Islam was a religion of hatred, and if Islam was a religion of terrorism and killing and fighting, do you really think we would all coexist in this beautiful way? In fact, this is a lesson for every one of us. Yes, we have gathered here in the center of the earth, in Makkatul Mukarrama, at the Kaaba, circumambulating this beautiful house 24/7. My brothers and sisters, can we not see that this is the message of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam? If we have differences with one another, we need to discuss them and we need to resolve them. We need to educate one another. We need to educate one another, my brothers and sisters. We need to reach out to one another. We need to be able to have a genuine feeling for one another. Never did Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam teach us that when we have a difference with our brother, we should kill him, we should harm him, we should attack him, we should backbite about him. That was never ever the teaching of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. So much so that, my brothers and sisters, if we were to look at the teachings of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, we would find that the closer we get to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the more we reach out to our brothers and sisters and to the rest of humanity. The more genuine the feeling that we have for everyone. Because, my brothers and sisters, a sign of closeness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and a sign of fulfillment of the duty unto Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is indeed that we become softened to the rest of the creatures of the same Maker. So from this beautiful place, I call on every one of you to learn to love one another for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to reach out to one another when you have differences, when there are things that happen that are not good, not kind. Learn to resolve them in a way that does not create bigger problems. My brothers and sisters, this is a gift of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And like I said, it's important for us to learn lessons. We all love to see this house of Allah. We all say, MashaAllah, Tabarakallah. We all say, wow, how good is this? How beautiful it is. It's the house of Allah. But the question we need to ask ourselves, do we actually fulfill the duties unto Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Do we actually fulfill our salah? This is the house of Allah. Do we pray? Do we actually fulfill our prayer for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? This is the house of Allah. Have we quit the sins that we've been engaging in for so many years when we see this house of Allah? Sometimes people come to the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but it does not change them. It does not turn them towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So my brothers and sisters, the big question is, if we are really and genuinely impressed by what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has placed in front of us here and His beautiful house, and we'd like to come here, we need to understand, let's change our lives. Let's become better people. Let's not make life difficult for those we live with, for those we interact with. Let's learn to make life easy for others. Allah will make life easy for us. Let's learn, my brothers and sisters, to quit the sins that we've been engaged in, whether it is drugs, whether it is pornography, alcohol, meaning the various forms of addictions that we have. Some are addicted to adultery as well, fornication, subhanAllah. People feel that this is light. It's not light, my brothers and sisters. It takes us away from our Maker. It takes us away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So my brothers and sisters, here we are pleading to Allah to forgive us, to grant us a new beginning, to give us from His mercy, to have mercy on humanity at large. We know there are people struggling across the globe. We know there are wars. There are people who are having bombs raining on them for no reason. They don't understand why that's happening to them. My brothers and sisters, let's pray for them. Let's ask Allah to help them. Ya Allah, we ask You to assist those, to help those who are struggling in any way, those who don't have homes, those who don't have food, those who don't have clothing across the globe, those who don't know where they are going, where they are heading, those whose homes have been snatched away from them, those whose homes have been destroyed, those who've been thrown out of their homes, those who've lost their loved ones, those who perhaps don't even know where their loved ones are because they've been displaced by war. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant ease to every one of them. My brothers and sisters, those from amongst you who are not married, may Allah grant you spouses who will be the coolness of your eyes. Those who don't have children, my brothers and sisters, I really pray that Allah bless you in every way and grant you the offspring and make them the coolness of your eyes. Ameen. So my brothers and sisters, I've been speaking for the last 12 minutes, and I'm sure every one of you really have things that you would like to call out to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for and with. So I ask Allah to grant you your du'as. Whatever du'a you make, may Allah accept it. May Allah accept all your du'as. There is a question. Ya Shaykh, hal yajuz as-sadaqa ala al-kuffar al-muhtajin? Na'am. Yajuz as-sadaqa ala al-kuffar al-muhtajin wa hum muhtajun. As-sadaqa, subhanallah. Wa kadhalika al-awla wal-afdal an tabhath an al-muslimin bi-idhnillahi azza wa jal fa'in lam توجد أو فإن وجد من الكفار من في حاجة وهم أمامك فيجوز طبعا يجوز الصدقة للكفار والله أعلم. That was someone asking me, are you allowed to give a charity to non-Muslims? And the answer is yes, you are. You are allowed to give charities to the non-Muslims as well. If you're allowed, subhanAllah, if you're encouraged to actually take care of the animals and be compassionate towards animals, then imagine another human being who doesn't share your faith, subhanAllah. So my brothers and sisters, this is something unique and amazing. This is a gift of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We reach out to humankind. We reach out to the cats and dogs as well, subhanallah. Like I mentioned earlier, compassion towards animals. There is a hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam making mention of how compassion towards a kitten actually earned the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for a female, and how compassion towards a dog earned the forgiveness of the man who was compassionate towards that dog. So here we go, my brothers and sisters, don't you all wish that you were here? I pray that Allah make you from among those who visits this place regularly. May Allah grant you sustenance, and may Allah grant you barakah in that sustenance. May Allah grant you blessings in every single way. Brothers and sisters, with lots and lots of love, I do say this is Makkatul Mukarrama, the Kaaba. I hope we feel this connection, and I hope we can actually be connected to one another in the same way that Allah has asked of us. And I know that there are people out there who think that we should be hating the Muslims that we have differences of opinion with. But I'd like to correct them to say that's wrong. We share the Shahada, and inshallah we will all be earning Jannatul Firdaus through this. So my brothers and sisters, I sign out by saying to all of you, please pray for me, and inshallah I will remember you as best as I can in my prayers. This was a video in order to make dua for one and all, and in order for you to see and to feel this, the spirituality of this beautiful place live. For indeed, there is no way that we could actually get the exact feeling unless and until we come here. But at least a live session would bring it closer to us. And I'm speaking to you from this beautiful place. If I can, I'm going to zoom in to the door of the Kaaba. If I can, I'm going to zoom in. There we are. There we are. Subhanallah. Look at the people. I'm going to try and stabilize this hand of mine and rest it a little bit. There we go. Subhanallah. All these people from all over the world, different colors, different sizes. The men wearing the same two pieces of cloth. Subhanallah. This goes to show that we are all one. We're all the same. We're all for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We're all on earth in order to try and please Him. And we will all be leaving and we will be going back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala soon. So my brothers and sisters, this beautiful place, that's the door of the Kaaba. Between the door and the Hajar is a place known as the Multazam, where the people used to actually, cling themselves onto that place and make dua to Allah. So I make dua from here for all of you, that Allah bless you. May Allah forgive me and forgive all of you. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all every form of mercy. My brothers and sisters, I sign off. I've been speaking for the last 16 minutes. أقول قولي هذا وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.